And now on BBC One, The Wednesday Play, a black comedy by up-and-coming writer Mike Leigh.
To Mr. O'Halligan, please. O'Halligan. Yes, he's big and bald with red hair. Yes, that's him.
Lawrence, you're going to get heartburn.
Mr. O'Halligan. Mr. Moss here, Wibbly Webb. Do you know I've been trying to get in touch with you all afternoon? Yes, I know you've been out. Now, what about that key to 15 Clittingham Avenue? Well, you were supposed to have it back by lunchtime. Well, will you be in tomorrow morning? Tonight? Where? Belfast? Well, what time is your plane? Or like your train? A party? I thought you said you were going to Belfast. Well, what time are you going to Kilburn? Well, what time are you having your bath? No, I'm not asking you to bath in cold water, Mr. O'Halligan. I'm simply after the key to 15 Clittingham Avenue. Well, I've got another client who wants to view the property. And what about you, Mr. O'Halligan? No, look, Mr. O'Halligan, if you want to come in on Monday morning with your deposit and go ahead and get in touch with your building society, then we'll see how things go. Until then, I need that key. All right, I will come and get it. Now.
Lawrence, no.
Yes, I know the address. Yes, I know how to get there. Thank you, I'll see you shortly. Goodbye. Stupid man.
Christ, Lawrence.
What?
Well, how long is all this going to take, please?
Oh, yes, I'm sorry, it won't take long.
Did you get those lagers?
No, I didn't have time.
Lawrence, well, you better get them when you go out. Don't forget, please.
Hello? Mrs. Cushing? Lawrence Moss here, Wibbly Webb. Yes, yes, we have finally located him, and you'll be pleased to know I'm now in the throes of retrieving the key. Not at all, not at all, all part of the service. Now, when would be best for you? No, I'll fall in with you. How about tomorrow morning?
Lawrence.
My pleasure, Mrs. Cushing, my pleasure. Now, what time would suit you best? No, I'm at your service. He who pays the piper calls the tune. Now, you name the hour and I shall appear. 8 o'clock. Surely.
Lawrence.
Early? No, not at all, Mrs. Cushing. Up with the lark, you know. My pleasure, Mrs. Cushing. I'll see you tomorrow. Bye-bye now. Bye-bye, Mrs. Cushing. Bye-bye.
You're going to kill yourself, you know, Lawrence.
Yes, well, it can't be helped.
It's ridiculous.
It's not a 9-to-5 job, Beverly. You know that.
Are you going to get changed?
Yes. I'll drink this, then I'll get changed, then I'll go out.
Don't forget those lagers.
Beverly, where are the olives?
In the kitchen, Lawrence. Lawrence, if you want olives, would you put them out, please?
They're early, aren't they?
No, they're not, and you've not changed.
Oh, I know that. Beverly, get the olives.
When you came round, made me feel really at home.
Yeah, well, Ange, I remember what it was like when I moved in here. It was lonely. And I thought to myself, that's not going to happen to you.
Well, you're the friendly type, aren't you?
Yeah. No, it's funny. I know we were going to get on as soon as we met.
Well, we're alike, aren't we?
Yeah.
Thank you.
Cheers, everyone.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Cheers, Tom.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Cheers. So what are you doing, darling? Are you staying or going?
I'll stay for a while, I think.
Lawrence has to pop out on business, I'm afraid, so... Now, would anybody like a cigarette? Lawrence, would you please? Angela. No, thanks. Tony, would you like a cigarette?
No, thank you.
We've just given up. Oh, yeah, sorry.
What, now, who'd like some olives?
No, not for me. And? Oh, no, thanks. Yeah. Tony, do you like olives?
No, I don't.
No, they're horrible, aren't they?
Yes.
Yeah, they've got a very bitter taste, haven't they, Ange?
Yeah.
Yeah. You see, I told you nobody would like olives, Lauren.
Oh, not nobody, Beverly. I like olives, and I'm 25% of the assembled company.
We've met you before, haven't we?
Really?
He is the one you remember, isn't he?
Yeah.
Do you remember us? We came looking for a house.
Oh, I can't say I do. Of course, I do see a lot of clients.
Yeah, we saw a lot of estate agents.
Yes, we went to all the ones in the area. We got the house from Spencer's in the end. Anthony Spencer.
Oh, yeah, Anthony Spencer, yeah.
Well, it was Nicholas Spencer who was dealing with us. He's very nice. Do you know him?
Yes, I know him.
Have you seen those boards they've got outside?
Oh, my, aren't they beautiful?
Oh, they're lovely. With the house and the garden and the family and the tree. When I saw those boards, I thought, I hope we get a house with one of those boards. I expect they sell lots of houses because of those boards, don't you think so?
No, actually, I don't.
Oh, don't you? We were lucky, actually, because we got the price down from $22,000 to
$21,000. Really? That is fantastic, Ange. That's really great. Is it your first house?
Yes. We were in a furnished flat before.
Oh, that's a bit grim, isn't it? Furnished flat, yeah? Mm.
Well, it was nice for us while we were saving.
Yeah.
But the trouble is, with it being furnished, we haven't got much furniture of our own together yet.
No, you feel it when you move, don't you?
Yeah.
Yeah. Mind you, your house is smaller than this one, yeah? Because I know they are smaller on your side of the road, yeah?
Yeah. These are lovely.
Yeah, dainty, aren't they? Mm. Oh, has your bed arrived yet, Ange?
Oh, don't talk about that. It's a sore point.
Is it?
Well, it's funny, really. I came home from work, because I'm not on nights anymore, I'm on days.
Yeah.
And I came home, and I saw this big parcel in the hall, and I saw his face, and he was looking furious, and I thought, what's happened? And do you know, the bed head had arrived, and no bed.
No, Ange. Did you hear that, Lawrence? How many weeks ago was it you ordered that bed, Ange?
Four.
4 weeks ago I ordered a bed and it still hasn't arrived.
Well, you can't trust anyone nowadays.
No, it's disgraceful. I mean, you've been sleeping on the floor, haven't you, Ange?
Yeah. Well, we got a mattress from Tony's mum, but it's not the same.
No. Well, let's face it. Can't do much with a bed head, can you, Tone? Do you know what I mean?
What line of business are you in?
Computers.
Oh, that is funny, Tony, because my brother's in computers, actually.
Is he?
Yeah, he's a programmes analyst. Yeah.
Tony's just an operator.
Well, I know it is a fantastic job, though, Tony, because my brother, he had to go to college and get exams. I mean, he was studying for years, wasn't he, Lawrence? Yeah. Did you have to do all that, Tony, you know, go to college?
You didn't really, did you? No.
Yeah, but I know it's a fantastic job though, Tom, because my brother, he has got a fabulous house and he gets great wages, you know, yeah.
9 to 5, is it?
No, it's not actually, there's quite a bit of variation.
Shift work?
It's a 2 weekly shift system. 1 week we work from 8 in the morning till 4 in the afternoon, and the following week we work from 4 till midnight. Get every other Saturday off.
Oh, fantastic. Were you off today, Tom?
Yeah, I was actually.
Yeah, and it's lucky really, because if I'm working on Saturday, he can do all the shopping.
Oh, and where do you shop?
Sainsbury's.
Oh, we usually use the Co-op. I find they have a much wider range of goods there.
Don't you find shopping boring though, Ed? Oh, I do. I hate it. No, he takes me down in the car. I get me wheelie time and I whiz in, I grab anything I can find, I bung it in me wheelie. He writes me a cheque, we bung it in the car, bring it home, you know, and it's done for the week, do you know what I mean?
I'm afraid Beverly isn't very organised. She doesn't believe in writing shopping lists. Do you have a car?
Yeah.
Yes, an escort.
A yellow one.
Fancy.
I've seen it.
Yeah, it is beautiful, actually.
Mm. Beverly was saying you only like minis.
Oh, no, not at all. No, I don't only like minis. No, I like a lot of other cars, sir. It's just that I find the mini economical, efficient, reliable, and the most suited to my purposes. Of course, I do change my car every year.
Yeah, but what I say, Angie, is this. What's the point in changing your car when all you change is the colour?
Well, that's not all you change, Beverly. The design does alter. But then you're not a motorist. You can't be expected to know these things.
Yeah, all right. I know. I failed my test 3 times.
3 times?
Yeah, but I'm his wife, Ange, and I reckon a wife should have a little say in the choosing of a car.
Well, when you've passed your test, Beverly, then you can have your little say. Until then, please leave it to me.
Let me put it to you this way, Ange. When we choose the furniture, we choose it together. When we choose the house, we choose it together. But when it comes to the car, I'm not allowed to say. Don't forget those light ales.
All the lagers, no.
Are you going to take your test again?
Yeah, I am going to have another try, yeah. No, it's not that I can't drive, Tom. Please don't think that. I'm a good driver. But when it comes to my test, it's my nerves that fail me. Do you know what I mean? I mean, it was my nerves that failed me the last time, to be honest with you. Because, you know, they take you out in threes time, right? Well, I'm behind this bloke, yeah? Well, it's a Chinese bloke, actually. Now, my bloke has told me to turn left, right? Now, we've come up to the first give way sign. This bloke in front of me slammed on his brakes. Now, I'm coming behind him. And I suppose, you know, I'm going a little bit too quick, what with my nerves. I slam on my brakes and smack into the back of him.
Ah.
Yeah. Now, I reckon that prejudiced my examiner against me.
What a shame.
Yeah, it is actually. Can you drive, Ange?
No. I'd like to learn, but Tony won't let me. He doesn't think I'll be any good. And it's a shame, because it's so awkward for me to get to work since we've moved.
Is it? Yeah.
Mm. And you see, I could use the car when he wasn't working.
Yeah. And that would make you completely independent of someone, wouldn't it? Yeah. Did you pass your test first time, Tom?
Yeah.
Yeah, I thought so, actually. It looks the type, doesn't it? Yeah.
Hmm.
Tell you what, you ready for another drink, Ange?
Thanks.
Yeah. How about you, Tony? Yeah, do you want a little top up?
So.
Nothing. Tony, I wonder if you could help me for a few moments, please.
Oh, the car start?
No.
Go on, Tony.
All right.
You mind you don't get dirt on your suit, Tony, all right?
Thanks.
Cheers.
Cheers.
If I asked you a little personal question?
No.
Yeah. Now, please don't be offended when I say this, but what colour lipstick are you wearing?
A pinky red.
A pinky red. Now, can you take a little bit of criticism? Yeah. Now, please don't be offended when I say this, but that is a very pretty dress, you may say. Now, if you see that ribbon down the front of your dress, Ange, if you had chosen a pink slightly nearer that colour, I think it would have blended more with your skin tones, do you know what I mean?
A paler colour.
A slightly paler colour, yeah. Now, can I give you a tip?
Yes.
Yeah. Now, I can see what you've done. You've just sat down in front of your mirror and you put your lipstick on. Now, I always used to tell this to my customers and it always works. Okay, what I want you to do, sit down in front of your mirror and relax and say to yourself, I've got very beautiful lips.
Yeah?
Then pick up your lipstick, Ange, and apply it. And you will see the difference. Because then you will be applying lipstick to every single corner of your mouth. Do you know what I mean?
Yes.
Will you try it for me next time?
Yes.
Yeah? You just sit down in front of your mirror, relax, and say to yourself,
I've got very beautiful lips.
And I promise you'll see the difference, Ange. Okay.
Thanks.
Yeah. Will you excuse me just a minute, Ange?
I'm sorry I'm a bit late.
Oh, no, that's all right, Sue. Don't you worry. Do you like me to take a cup?
Yes, thank you.
So, is everything all right, Sue?
Yes, I think so. I hope so.
Come through and say hello.
Ange, this is Sue. Sue, this is Ange.
Hello, how do you do?
Sue's from number 9.
Oh, we've just moved into number 16.
Oh, you know the McDonald's old house, Sue?
Yes, yes.
Sit down, Sue. I'm just going to pop your coat in the hall, okay? Won't be a sec.
Thank you.
Make yourself at home, Sue.
We've only been here a fortnight.
Oh, yes. Did you bring this one?
Yes.
Oh, is it for us?
Yes.
Oh, thank you, Sue.
It's nothing very special, I'm afraid.
Isn't that kind, Ange?
Yes, not at all.
Ah, lovely, because Lawrence likes a drop of wine, actually. Oh, fantastic, Beaujolais. Mm. Oh, one sec. I'm just going to pop it in the fridge, all right?
I'm so pleased to meet you, because I wanted to meet all the neighbours.
Yes. Now, so, what would you like to drink?
I'll have a glass of sherry, thank you.
Sherry? Are you sure?
Yes, please.
Because we've got everything. There's gin, whiskey, vodka, brandy, anything you'd like. So, would you like a little gin and tonic? Because me and Ange are drinking gin and tonic, actually.
All right, then. Thank you.
Yeah. Ice and lemon?
Yes, please.
Great.
It's a nice drink, isn't it, gin and tonic?
Yes, it is.
Refreshing. Sometimes I'll drink lager and lime. Say I'm in the pub with my husband, I'll drink that. But I prefer this.
Can I wash my hands, please?
Oh, won't be a sec, Tom. I'm just going to finish making Sue's drink, all right? I'm sorry, Sue. This is Tommy.
My husband.
How do you do?
How'd you do?
Did you wash it all right?
Yeah, battery was flying.
Sue?
Thank you.
Cheers.
Oh, cheers.
Tom, hands. Okay, what's it going to do? Soap and towel just on there, okay?
Tom.
Do you work?
No, I don't.
I'm a nurse.
Oh, really?
At St Mary's in Walthamstow.
Oh, yes.
Beverly was saying your daughter's having a party. Is that right?
Yes, that's right.
Has it started yet?
Yes, it has.
You all right, Tom?
Oh, yes, thank you.
Yeah, like to come through?
Thanks. The drink's just on there.
Like to take a seat?
Tom.
Now, Sue, would you like a little cigarette?
Oh, no, thank you.
No? Perhaps you'll have one a little bit later on then, yeah? And I know Angela doesn't want one.
No.
So is everybody all right?
Lovely
yes,
face.
Yes,
yeah.
Thank you.
Great. Aye. I think it started, Sue.
They've got the record player going, haven't they? They're going to have fun, aren't they?
It sounds like it.
I hope so.
How old is she, your daughter?
She's 15.
Oh, what does she look like? Because I might have seen her.
Oh, well, she's quite tall, with fair hair, quite long fair hair.
She hasn't got a pink streak in it, has she?
Yes.
Yeah, that's Abigail. And she wears those jeans, Ange, you know, with the patches on and all those safety pins down the side and those scruffy bottoms.
Yes, I've seen her.
And plumber's overalls.
Yeah, plumber's overalls. She makes me die, you know.
Yes, I've seen her. She was standing outside your gate with a friend. And you've seen her too, haven't you? Getting off that motorbike.
Yeah.
How many people are coming to the party?
It's about 15, isn't it, Sue?
Well, it was 15, and then it went up to 20. Last night I gathered it was 25.
Oh, it's creeping up, Sue.
I've told her that's the limit. Well, I think that's enough, don't you?
Oh, definitely, yes. Sue. Yeah, definitely. Mind you, this is the problem with teenagers, isn't it? They tell you 25, but then a friend invites a friend, that friend invites another friend. Before you know it, you've got 70 or 80 turning up. This is it, this is the danger.
Just saw a couple of people arriving, actually.
Yes. nice of them to help you with the car.
Oh no, not them. A couple of coloured chaps and a girl roared up in a full capri.
Really? Well, there were only half a dozen there when I left. When I was asked to leave.
Oh, this is it, you see. They don't want them sitting there, do they? Casting a beady eye over the goings on, no.
No, not when they get to 15, they don't. When I was 15, I really wanted to have a party, but my dad, he wouldn't let me. You see, I've got four sisters, haven't I, Tony?
Yeah.
And you see, I think he was a little bit worried that I'd invite all my friends and they'd bring along a few of theirs and would end up with a house full.
Yeah, well, this is it, isn't it?
And I think he was a bit worried about people pinching things and things getting broken.
Do you lock your silver away, sir?
No, I haven't got any. Well, not much anyway. I put a few things upstairs, just in case of accidents.
Yes, it's better to. Because they can easily happen. Like that egg timer. Tony was furious. It was a wedding present.
So please don't think I'm saying any of Abigail's friends are thieves. Please don't think that. It's just that you don't know who you get at a party, do you? And let's face it, people can be light-fingered.
Yes.
Yeah. Do you leave your carpets down, sir?
Yes.
Have you got fitted carpets?
Yes.
We've got fitted carpets. The McDonald's left them all, and they were inclusive in the price of the house.
Really?
Yes, we were lucky actually, because we got the price down from $22,000 to
$21,000. Oh.
I don't know what we'll do about our carpets when we have a party. Because we're going to have a party soon, aren't we?
Housewarming.
Yeah, you'll have to come.
Thank you.
This is the thing though, isn't it, with fitted carpets, you know? Particularly with teenagers, you don't know what to do for the best. I mean, let's face it, they are not as careful as, say, we would be. Do you know what I mean? They don't think. You know, they've got a drink in one hand, a cigarette in the other, having a little bit of a dance. Next thing you know, it's cigarette on your carpet and stubbed out.
Is it your daughter's birthday?
No, she just wanted a party, no particular reason.
Let's face it, they don't need a reason these days, do they? Any excuse for a bit of a rave up, isn't it? What do they call it? A freak out. Oh, do you get that beer, sir?
Yes, I got four of those big tins and some pomade.
Oh, that's nice, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
Yeah, it's funny. At that age, we used to drink Bournemouth cider. Yeah, we used to say a glass of cider and she's anybody's.
I got very drunk on champagne at our wedding. Do you remember?
Yeah.
Gives you a terrible headache, champagne, though, doesn't it?
Yeah, in the morning.
Yeah, shocking. Do you get any spirits, though?
No, I didn't.
No, you're very wise. Because they're very expensive, aren't they? And let's face it, if they want to drink spirits, they can buy their own. Or particularly the older boys, because they're working, aren't they? I mean, there will be older boys at the party, won't there?
Oh, yes.
Yeah. Well, let's face it, Ange. When you're 15, you don't want to go out with a bloke who's 15, do you?
No.
Because they're babies, aren't they? I mean, when I was 15, I was going out with a bloke who was 21. How's Abigail getting on with her bloke, by the way, Sue?
I'm not sure. I don't ask.
Might you? I reckon you're better to let her go out with as many blokes as she wants to at that age rather than just the one. Don't you agree with me, Ange?
Yes. How many boyfriends has she got?
I don't know. I'm not sure she knows herself, really.
Oh, footloose and fancy free.
Actually, Sue, I've been thinking. It might be a good idea if, a little bit later on, when Lawrence gets back, if him and Tony go down there. Now, I don't mean to go in, but you know, just check over the place, make sure everything's all right. Don't you agree with me, Ange?
Yes, it's a good idea. You don't mind, do you?
No.
Oh, it's very nice of you, but I don't think it'll be necessary.
Husband away then, is he?
No, we've split up, actually.
Are you separated or divorced?
Divorced.
When did you get divorced?
3 years ago.
Oh. Well, I suppose that's sort of given you time to get used to it then, hasn't it? We've been together 3 years. 3 years in September.
Well, that's funny. Lawrence and I have been together 3 years, actually.
Oh, really? We were all getting married about the same time as you were getting divorced. It's funny, isn't it?
What a coincidence.
Yes.
Where is he now, do you know?
He doesn't live far from here, actually.
Oh, that's nice. Do you keep in touch?
Yes, he comes round every Sunday.
Yeah, pops over to see the kids, doesn't he, Sue?
For lunch, yes.
I see. Is he coming tomorrow?
I expect so.
Oh, that's nice, isn't it, for the kids?
Yeah, well, let's face it, so whatever you say about him, he is still their father, isn't he?
Yes.
Yeah. Mind you, I don't agree with sticking together for the sake of the kids. To me, this is wrong. Now, take my parents, for example, yeah? Now, you may not believe this, Sue, but it is the truth. My parents have not spoken to each other for 20 years. For as long as I can remember, my father has slept in the box room on his own.
Well, that's like my mum and dad. My dad's terrible to my mum.
Is he?
He hardly speaks to her.
Yeah, and it's not fair, is it, Ange? I mean, look at my mum, right? Now, she's 60. She's ever so sweet. She wouldn't hurt a fly. But she's really on with her nerves. You know why? The result of all the rails that have been going on.
Well, that's like my mum. She's been really ill for the last 5 years. Seriously ill with a blood disease.
Oh.
She might die at any moment.
Really?
Yeah, but it doesn't make any difference. My dad's as rotten to her as he's always been.
Yeah, you see, it's not fair. Now, you know, this is the truth. If my father were to drop dead tomorrow, I wouldn't care. Because I hate him. We all hate him. But you see him? He'll live till he's at least 90. Whereas your mum, bless her, she could do with her good health and she hasn't got it. Mm. And to me, this is all wrong.
Well, that's like Tony's dad. I mean, he just walked out on Tony's mum. And you were only about 3, weren't you?
Like living around here, do you, sir?
Yes, it's a very pleasant area.
What does your husband do?
He's an architect.
Oh. Well, that's a good job, isn't it?
Yes,
yeah, it's a good job, architect, yeah.
Well paid.
It can be. Training's quite long ago.
Yes.
Is David remarried, sir?
Yes.
Oh, well, it's a good job he's got a good job then, isn't it? I mean, if he's got 2 families to support.
Oh, have they got children now, sir?
No, but she wants some, so I think they're trying. But I don't think they've had any success so far.
Does she come round on Sunday?
No, he comes on his own.
Oh. But I suppose, like, when your kids go round there, it's like she's got a little ready-made family.
Well, they don't, actually. Well, oh, hardly ever.
Don't you get on with her?
No. Well, I hardly know her, really.
Well, if your husband runs off with another woman, well...
Yeah, I mean, let's face it, Ange. You're hardly going to be the best of mates, are you?
No.
Now, let's for another drink. Ange.
Thanks.
Yeah. Sue, so, would you like another drink?
No, thank you. I've still got some.
Yeah, we'll just give you a little top-up there, Sue, all right?
Yeah.
So, tell me, would you like another drink?
So?
I think people are getting divorced these days more often.
Definitely, yeah, definitely. Mind you, I blame a lot of it on women's lib, I do. And on permissiveness and all this wife-swapping business. Don't you, Tom?
I suppose so.
Don't you, sir?
Possibly.
Yeah, I mean, take Peter Sellers, for example, yeah? Now, he's been married at least 5 or 6 times.
4, actually.
Is it 4, sir?
Well, look at Richard Burton and Elizabeth Taylor.
Yeah, you see, now, to me, their relationship is ridiculous. Mm-hmm. I think they make a mockery of marriage. I think it's disgusting.
They only do it for publicity.
Yeah. I think a lot of the time with these film stars, you know, the attraction is purely... physical, you know?
Mm. Yeah. They did it in the jungle.
Yeah. And the other thing with these film stars, yeah? Now, to them, getting divorced is like, we'll go into the lavatory, if you'll pardon my French. But to us, it's a big wrench, isn't it, Sue?
Yes, of course it is.
Yeah.
Yes.
But I think these film stars get married because the public expects it.
Do you?
Yes, I do.
I think people take divorce for granted. I think if they stuck at it, they'd be all right. Don't you?
Yeah. Mind you, Ange, let's face it, there are times when you come bashing over the head with a rolling pin and clear out, you know what I mean?
Mm. Well, that's like me and Tony. I mean, we've only been together nearly 3 years. We're always having rows, aren't we?
Yeah.
Did he give you a bad time, Tony?
Tough. Shocking.
And I think it spoils things, doesn't it?
Yes, it does.
Mind you, I reckon a little row can add a sparkle to a relationship, you know.
Did you row your husband a lot?
No, we didn't, actually.
Oh.
Well, there you go. You see, it doesn't always follow, does it? Funny, isn't it? Do you think people should get married, Tom?
Sometimes.
Oh, he's not so sure anymore, since he's been married to me.
Perhaps we should all just live in sin and forget the whole thing. I don't know.
Did you live with Lawrence before you married him?
No, I didn't, actually.
Do you think if you had done, you'd still have got married?
No, I don't honestly think I do. If we had, say, lived together for a year or so beforehand, I don't honestly think it would have worked out, no.
I think if you're going to have kids, you'll get married.
Oh, definitely, Tom. Give them a name, yeah.
Yes.
Mind you, you'll be having all this soon, so won't you? Do you think Abigail's the marrying type?
I hope so.
Oh, you might be getting married again yourself soon.
I don't think that's very likely.
Well, you never know, because I never thought anyone would want to marry me. But then I met Tony, and we were married within a year, weren't we?
8 months.
So you see, it can happen.
Really?
Yeah. Have you got a boyfriend?
No.
Oh.
Do you want kids, Ange?
Yes, I do.
Yeah, do you, Tom?
Not for a while.
Not till we've settled in.
Oh, no, yeah, get yourself sorted first, yeah. And you'd make a good dad, wouldn't he?
Yeah.
Yeah. I can just see you, you know, yeah, with a little boy, taking him out, looking after him, yeah.
Be nice to have one of each.
Yeah, like Sue. Mind you, to me, Sue's kids, Abigail and Jeremy aren't a bit alike, are they, Sue?
No, they're not.
Oh, they're like chalk and cheese, aren't you?
Do they take after you or your husband?
Neither of us, really. Jeremy looks more like my brother, and Abigail doesn't look like anyone in the family.
The black sheep, eh? So, how did your Jeremy get on packing his overnight bag?
Oh, he loved it.
Did he, yeah? Sue was telling me he was so excited about packing all his little things.
He'd have taken the kitchen sink if I let him.
Where's he gone?
Round the corner.
How old is he?
11 and a half.
Do you want children?
No, I don't think I do. Don't get me wrong. It's not that I don't like kids because I do. But I wouldn't like to actually have to have them, you know? I mean, did you have your kids in hospital, sir?
Yes.
Did you have an easy labour?
Well, Abigail was very difficult, but Jeremy was fine. He was born very quickly.
Yeah, you see, to me, having kids, going into hospital, no, it's just not me at all. Oh, and don't get me wrong, I know this sounds horrible, but all that breastfeeding and changing nappies, no, it make me heave. I really don't think I've got that motherly instinct in me, you know?
You see, it'd be different for me, because I'm used to looking after children.
Yeah.
And you see, once you've looked after a ward full of sick children, you can easily manage a couple of your own.
Oh, yeah.
You see, the thing about children that are ill is you've got to watch them every minute. Because recently we had this little girl, she's only about 2, but she kept picking at her dressing. She got it all off and got right down into the wound.
I'm sorry, Ange. Would you mind stopping? It's just that if you carry on, I think I might faint.
Yeah, leave it out, Ange.
No, it's all right, because she wasn't in any pain, but she got it all off and she got right into the
stick. Drop it!
Did you know my husband was a professional footballer?
Really?
Yeah, he used to play for Crystal Palace, didn't you?
Yeah.
Oh, that is fantastic.
This was before I knew him.
What, did you play for the reserves, Tom?
No, it was the first team.
Honestly, is that true?
Yeah.
You're not kidding me?
No.
The first time, honestly?
Yeah.
That is fantastic. Hey, Sam. Didn't know we had a celebrity moved into Richmond Road, did we?
No, we didn't.
Ah. Yeah, that is fantastic, Tom, actually. It's made my night. Yeah. Lawrence? Excuse me a minute. Lawrence?
Nice music, isn't it, Tony?
Would you want one of these, sir?
Thank you.
Ta, I shouldn't really be eating these, because we had a big tea earlier. Did you eat earlier?
No, I didn't.
Oh, you must be hungry.
Here, have a peanut.
Thank you.
Are you having a barbecue?
No.
Oh. Because it's a nice idea if you've got a big garden.
Yes.
I'd love to have a barbecue. You know, do baked jacket potatoes.
Lovely.
Sausages and chops, and you could do chestnuts, and we could have an ox, you know, on a spit.
Oh, so it's all happening down at your place. And it's so funny, yeah? So you know your bay window at the front? Right, well the window's wide open, and there's this bloke. He's got to be 20 stone, and he's wedged in your bay window, so. He's got all those purple vests on, you know, and this great big fat belly. Oh, and there's this girl, right, standing in your garden, yeah? She's as thin as he's fat. She's got her arms draped round him like this, and they're snogging away. Oh, and she's the funniest thing you've ever seen.
Oh, dear.
Oh, no, Sue, don't worry. Come on, they're only teenagers. They're only having a bit of fun, eh?
I wonder if I dare just pop down there for a minute.
Would you like me to go and have a look for you now?
No.
Tony doesn't mind.
It's not a problem.
No, it's fine. I think perhaps it's better not.
Yeah, I think Sue's right. Yeah, better not for the moment. I mean, as I say, they're only having a bit of fun, aren't they? And let's face it, when Lawrence gets back, we can discuss it then, can't we, yeah? Now, we'd like another drink, yeah? Come on, Ange. How about you, Sue? Yeah?
No, thank you.
Yeah, that's it. We'll just give you a little top-up, settle your nerves, yeah? Tony, would you like another drink?
Top.
Oh, what a lovely table. Oh, this is what we really need. Because at the moment, we're eating off our knees.
Yeah. It was expensive, that one, actually, yeah.
And I'd really love one of these.
The candelabra. It's brilliant, isn't it? Yeah.
Is it real silver?
Yeah. Silver plate, yeah.
And it looks so nice with the light.
So,
thank you.
Excuse me.
So, where is Lawrence anyway?
I don't know actually, Tony. I wish I did know, yeah. So, I do apologise. You must think I'm so rude. I haven't offered you anything to eat, have I? Now, stay there. Here, take some peanuts.
Thank you.
Yeah. Have some crisps as well, so, yeah.
Thank you.
Now, so, a little cheesy pineapple one.
Thank you.
Tom, a little cheesy pineapple one.
Tom.
Here, Sue, take another one, save me back.
Thank you.
Sit. Now, Sue, would you like that little cigarette?
Not just at the moment, thank you.
No? Alright, so I'll tell you what I'll do. I'll pop it on here for you, and you can light it when you've finished those, okay?
Tony, come and have a look at this beautiful kitchen.
Yeah, it is lovely, isn't it?
These tiles are gorgeous.
Yeah.
Were they here when you came?
Yeah, they were. We were very lucky, actually.
You were. Because our kitchen is nothing like this. Tony, come and have a look.
Yeah, go on, Tony, go and have a look. They are beautiful, actually. Go and have a look, go on.
Tony! Is this a fridge? Freezer part? Your fridge?
Yeah, it's the freezer on top, yeah.
Oh.
It's nice, isn't it?
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah, they're a very nice couple actually, yeah.
Yes.
Oh, the sink's got its own light.
Leave it.
And you got one of these.
What? Oh, the rotisserie, yeah. Yeah.
Do you cook chickens and beans on it?
Well, you can do, yeah. I'm not much of a cook myself, so I haven't actually used it, but yeah. You can also do kebabs on there, apparently. They are very nice.
Lovely.
Yeah. Would you excuse me just a second?
Oh, hello, Sue. Are you all right?
Yes, fine, thank you.
Lawrence, where have you been?
To the off licence.
Right, well, don't want to go in the fridge to chill, OK? Sorry, Anne. Sorry, son. Come. Thanks.
Thank you.
Nice to sit down. Now, Sue, shall we have that little cigarette?
Yeah.
say so.
Thank you.
Now, everybody all right?
Lovely,
yes,
Ben.
Thank you.
Right, now who'd like a drink? Tony, light ale?
No, I'm all right, thank you.
Oh, you go on, Tony, have a little light ale. Because he's got them specially for you.
Oh, if he doesn't want one, he doesn't have to have one, Beverly. So?
No, thank you.
Angela?
No, I'm all right, thanks.
Beverly?
No, I'm fine, thank you.
Lawrence? Yes, please, I'd love one. Thank you very much. Well, the party certainly seems to be hotting up at your place, sir.
Yes, so Beverly said.
Actually, Lawrence, we were just saying, it might be a good idea if, you know, a little bit later on, if you and Tony pop down there.
What for?
Just to have a look at the place, you know, check it over for Sue. Put her mind at rest, because I know she's a little bit worried.
I really don't think it'll be necessary.
No, Sue, I don't think there'll be any problems.
No.
I'm not saying there'll be any problems, Lawrence. I'm just saying, would you pop down there for Sue?
Well, I've just been past and there doesn't seem to be anything at all. Everything's okay.
Didn't you see what was happening in the garden?
Well, yeah, I saw a couple in the porch and there were a few more down the side, but I didn't see anybody in the garden.
Didn't you see the couple snogging through the window?
No, as I say, I saw a couple through the porch and some in the front garden, but I didn't see anybody snogging through the window.
Oh.
Would you like to sit here, Lawrence?
No, 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 you stay there. You stay there.
Come and sit down here. There's plenty of room.
Thank you. Yes, anyway, Sue, these sort of things, they do happen at parties. I'm sure it's nothing to worry about.
Yes, of course.
Actually, Lawrence, I think you're being very unfair to Sue.
Oh, no, not at all.
No, now, Sue, don't make excuses for him. And apart from anything else, Tony has already agreed to go, actually.
Oh, have you?
Yeah.
Yes, well, I didn't say I wouldn't go. If Sue wants us to go, then surely we'll go.
Well, I don't know that I do, really.
Fine.
You don't mind going down on your own, do you?
No, I don't mind.
I didn't say I wouldn't go.
Fine. Are you going then, Lawrence, please?
Yes.
Thank you.
That's quite all right.
You know, I'm not saying there'll be any problems, you know, but with teenagers, they have a few drinks, they get overexcited.
Yes, well, it starts with one kiss.
Yeah, and then they find their way to the bedroom.
So, do you like olives?
Yes.
Fine, I'll get you some.
Thank you.
You've got a friend there for life, so...
Oh?
None of us like olives, you see.
Oh, I see.
I can't stand them. It's those stuffed olives. You know the one with the little red bit sticking out? Oh, well, it reminds me of... Well, I'm not going to say what it reminds me of, but I can't stand them. It puts me off.
So?
Thank you.
Well, not everyone can like everything, can they? It's like Tony. He doesn't like curry, and I love it. So we never go to Indian restaurants now, do we?
No.
And you can get English food in an Indian restaurant. You can get chips with your meal instead of rice.
Yeah.
But you see, Tony had a bad experience in an Indian restaurant. This was before I knew him.
Right.
He had a bad dose of gastroenteritis. And you see, that put him off.
Oh, yeah.
And he won't even eat it at home now. And I enjoy making it. It's a good way of using up leftovers. Have you ever tried pilchard curry?
No.
Oh, now that is a very economical dish. You just get one of those big tins of pilchards in tomato sauce, add a couple of onions and some curry powder, and it's really nice.
Oh.
But you see, Tony won't touch it. But then again, I don't like Turkish delights, and he loves that.
Darling, have you got heartburn?
No.
Have you got heartburn?
Just a little touch of indigestion, that's all.
I knew it. You see, Ed, he comes in late from work and he's all upset because he's very highly strung, Sue, and that gives him heartburn.
Oh, he must be careful then, because when I was working on intensive care, those that had a cardiac arrest, they were nearly all businessmen and those that were stressed about their work.
I hope you're listening to this, Lawrence.
Yes, I'm listening. Cigar?
No, thank you. Just giving up.
Are you sure?
Yeah, go on, Tony. Take a little cigar. Enjoy yourself. Go on, take one.
Yes, go on, take one.
Hey.
Tony! Well, that counts, doesn't it? I mean, if he's having a cigar...
Yeah, go on, Edge.
So?
Oh, no, thank you.
Some women do like them, you know.
Yes, so I understand, but I have a cigarette.
Oh, yes. Light.
Of course, smoking is one of the chief causes of heart disease.
But it's just contributory, isn't it?
Well, yes, but if you've got a tendency towards that condition, then you really shouldn't smoke.
Oh, no, 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 I'm sure that smoking in moderation doesn't cause any damage.
Lawrence, would you like to put a record on for us, please?
Surely. What would you like to hear?
Feliciano.
Oh, no, Beverly. We don't want to listen to that blind Spaniard caterwauling all night.
Darling, not classical.
Light classical. Just as a background. Sue, do you know James Galway?
Yes, I've heard him.
He's a very up-and-coming young flautist. He's very good.
Yes, he is very good.
Oh, go on, I'll put him on for you.
Now, Lawrence, I'm sorry, we do not want to listen to classical music at the present moment.
Well, what do you want to listen to?
Feliciano.
Well, if everybody wants to listen to Feliciano, then we'll put him on.
Tony, do you like Feliciano?
Yeah, I do.
Yeah, he's fantastic, isn't he? So, do you like him?
I don't know him, I'm afraid.
Oh, you'll like him. He's lovely.
Yeah, so he is great. So, do you want to hear him?
Yes.
Yeah? Lawrence, Angela likes Feliciano, Tony likes Feliciano, I like Feliciano, and Sue would like to hear Feliciano. So please, do you think we can have Feliciano on?
Yes.
Thank you.
Oh, it changes colour, doesn't it?
What, the fire below? Yeah, it's beautiful, isn't it?
It's lovely.
Yeah. Do you know what I do sometimes, Ange? I put on a record, yeah? I sit in that chair and I just gaze at it for hours.
Do you?
Yeah. It always reminds me of America. I don't know why, but it does.
Oh, yes. New York, isn't it?
Yeah, I suppose it is, really.
How are you enjoying your cigar?
Very nice, thank you. How's your cigarette?
Oh, it's lovely. Mind you don't choke on it. He's not used to smoking cigars. He doesn't know what to do with it.
Oh, he'll be all right. Now, who's for another drink? Ange?
Thank you.
Yeah, Tony, would you like another drink?
Top.
Yeah, about you, Sue?
No, thank you.
Yeah, that's it. We'll just give you a little top up, Sue. Settle your nerves, yeah?
Yes, I've often regretted it. You know, I think musicians and artists, they're very lucky people. They've got one great advantage in life. Do you know what that is? Their talent. I wish I'd been born with a talent like that. Most people just drift through life without any real aims. They're weak. It's no good just sitting there whining. Oh no, you've got to get up and do something about it. Not that it's easy. Oh no, life is a fight. People always seem to be against you. Not that I've done badly. No, I've done quite well. Oh yes.
I once went to a party and they said, can anyone play the piano? And I said, oh yes, I can. But you see, I can't play the piano. I just learned this one tune from a friend. It was, buy a broom, buy a broom, buy a broom and sweep the room.
Yeah.
And they wanted me to play for musical chairs. So I played it a few times, buy a broom, buy a broom. And then I thought, well, I'm going to have to do something different. So I started, you know, just...
Oh, what, vamping?
Yeah. But the trouble is, because I can't play, it sounded awful. And I felt so foolish. I thought, why did I say, you know, I could play?
How old was this age?
Oh, it was only when I was 8.
Oh, sweet.
Oh, but I still felt a fool, though.
Now, actually, would anybody mind if I turn this track up? Because it's my favourite, actually, is Light My Fire. And I'd like us all to hear it. Does anybody mind?
No.
No?
Great.
It's fantastic, isn't it? Do you like the match?
Yeah. It's a pity he's blind, though.
Yeah. Mind you, I reckon it makes him more sensitive. Do you know what I mean? Do you know? I first started listening to this 8 years ago. This used to turn me on at parties, you know, Tom. That's how long I've liked him. Oh, wait. Can you imagine making love to this, yeah? Right, lad.
Are you ready, Tony?
Thank you, Lawrence.
Don't mention it. Are you coming?
What for? Where?
Well, if Sue wants us to go and inspect the party, and I think we should go and inspect it.
Fine, would you like to go now?
I am going.
It'd be better if you...
Yeah, now don't worry, Sue.
Are you going?
Yeah.
I really think it would be better if you didn't.
It's all right, just take a little walk past, make sure everything's all right.
Don't worry. Tony will handle it.
I'll be long.
Take care. Yeah, I'm sorry about that, folks.
Oh, that's all right. Would you like me to put the record on again?
No, don't bother, Ange, because he's spoilt it, actually.
Oh. And you were enjoying yourself.
Yeah, well, we were all enjoying ourselves, weren't we? Quite honest with you, he was a boring little bugger at times, actually. Anyway, sod him. Come on, let's all have another drink, yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah, come on, Ange. So?
Oh, no, really.
Yeah, come on, we'll just give you a little top up. I'll tell you what. Let's all get pissed, yeah?
Yeah, we can have fun.
Yeah, so right. That's it, and you.
Cheers.
There you go, Sue. Cheers.
Thank you.
Cheers, Ange.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Tell you what, Sue. Ange, let's have another little fag while they're out as well, yeah?
Yeah, why not?
I think I'm going to be sick.
Oh. Are you? Well, come along then.
Yeah, come on, Sue.
Where's your toilet?
It's in the hall under the stairs, yeah?